In the forgotten room, a relic. Breaking the circle. Prevent the summoning. A greater enemy, but also a greater reward. Thank you. Mary had already started studying Margaret's books of potion making and recipes before the disaster had struck. She worked through them cautiously and patiently. After all, someone had to follow in Grandma's footsteps and help the family in their efforts. Never before had the Bergsons seen, nor had they heard, such a vast trove of myth and legends. They were so mesmerized by Apan's storytelling that they spent the whole night transfixed as her audience. so innocent game of chance and memory. old man explained that yesterday's secrets and even tomorrow's legends can be found written in the stars. Unfortunately, an eyeglass broken in yesterday's haste would not allow vision into tomorrow's unknown. The sage looked upon the Bergson for help. The nearby mines could luckily supply the materials needed to craft a new lens. All the young boy would need was someone to watch over him while he gathered them. The wish that their mother was alive was a shared longing for Ben and John. The younger son placed Margaret's staff on the same pedestal he had taken his father's sword from, his mind wondering about the truth of the horrific secret that their mother had left for them in her final letter. Soon, the Bergsons would have to face Bushra, the villainous ruler of Barahut and lover of the Wind Spirit. Agitated, Ben was pointing out the passes that led to the halls of Anairaha. John, however, was lost in his thoughts. Thoughts that only Mark could guess.
Breaking, ever shaking, everlasting.